Hello friends, in this session we'll be taking a look at the multi-instance loop and the simple loop features of a process. So in a process earlier known as BPD, you can make any activity either a loop of simple loop type or multi-instance loop type. A simple loop is basically it will run in sequence for that many number of iterations. Let's take a look at multi-instance loop. For multi-instance loop, the options are start quantity. So generally you will have a list variable of a simple type or a complex type, and then you will iterate the multi-instance loop for the length of the list. So that's done using this method. And then ordering can be run in parallel or run sequential. Generally, parallel run is preferred whenever we want to launch n number of tasks parallelly. In terms of linkages, you can have different kinds of implementations. You can link a process or utilize a sub-process, script, decision task, system task, and even a user task also. Now let's take a look at how the data passed into the implementation, which could be a task, which could be a linked sub-process. So the key word to be used is tw.system.step.counter. So this is basically the sequence of the instance within the multi-instance. That means the very first invocation will be one, but since in an array, array is a zero index based construct, so we'll be doing tw.system.step.counter -1 to pass in the data from our bound list for which we are iterating the multi-instance loop. So let's take a look at the other features. Flow condition. We will have a use case scenario where there will be n number of approvers given a task, and the scenario is like this: any one of the approver in n can approve it, and as soon as he approves it, it completes the approval process and the remaining ones should be cancelled. To implement this kind of a use case, we will have to use a complex flow condition. The other option was to wait for all to finish. In that use case, basically all the approvals should come in. But in a conditional wait, we just want any particular one to approve it, and the remaining task will be cancelled out and we'll move on to the next step. So keep in mind, if we do not select cancel remaining instances, what will happen is on completion of one approval, the process will move forward. But if the other users complete the other approvals, additional tokens, parallel tokens, will be introduced into the system and it will become a parallel flow. So now let's try to run it and see how it works in practice. So we are going to run the process, and we have defined a variable which has 10 members within it. As you can see, the list has 10 items within it, so we should be expecting to see 10 instances of the multi-instance loop created. As you can see by the token identifiers, there are 10 tasks created. So the conditional wait specifies that if any one particular task is completed, remaining ones should cancel out and the process should move to the next step. So let's pick up any one of the 10 tasks and see how it works. So I'll complete this activity, and we have marked a variable on completion of the activity approved, which will be set to true. So as you can see, the entire instance has completed. It's in the completed state, and all the remaining tasks have gotten closed. Based on actual implementation experiences, it has been noticed that multi-instance loops can create performance problems on a very large scale in the system. Because what happens is all the parallel paths are executed and it puts a simultaneous load on the system. So it is advisable to not have the first activity within a multi-instance loop as a system activity, because system activity, especially if it is a bulky activity, all will be parallelly executing and will bog down the system. It is ideal to have the very first task within a multi-instance loop as a user task, because the actual effort in creating a user task is lesser than running a system activity in parallel. So these are all the niceties around implementing a multi-instance loop.